Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Final Mix playthrough. It is time for us to head on down to the Dwarf Woodlands.
What has happened here?
Poor Snow White. She was just as sweet as could be.
She sang us pretty songs.
And made us smile.
At bedtime, she told wonderful stories.
About falling in love with the prince she'd met.
And when we went to work, she gave us all a kiss.
She was so full of kindness. Why, she made better folk of all of us.
From what you've said, she must have been very loved. But how did this happen to her?
A wicked queen was horribly jealous of our dear Snow White's beauty. So she used her evil magic to change into an old hag. Then she gave Snow White a poisoned apple.
And by the time we got here, well, it was just too late. We found the princess as still as can be. Nothing we could do would wake her.
Isn't there some way we can help her?
Well, not unless somebody craves the vassal. I'll brave the castle.
All you fools can stay here doing nothing. But I'm not afeard of going, not even to that witch's lair.
You'll never make it. The castle's supposed to be guarded by magic and crawling with monsters.
All right, then I'll go.
You will?
I will. Leave it to me.
Well, all right, my dear. We'd be much obliged.
So yes, Aqua's introduction to the Dwarf Woodlands is a very sad one, and there's Snow White sleeping away. And actually what this begins to introduce is the fact that generally Aqua is always the one who comes in, or generally always the one that comes in at the end of a world story to do the cleanup, basically. Because it happens here, it happens in Enchanted Dominion, it happens in Castle of Dreams. I'm trying to think. Is there anywhere else where it happens? I think on the second loop it is not necessarily as big a thing, although I'm pretty sure that Olympus Coliseum, she's the last to visit that one. And in certainly our run, she's also going to be the last to visit the Disney Town. So Deep Space Ben's the last one there, and I believe that in Neverland, Ven's the last one there in that one as... Ooh, or actually, no. I think Aqua might be the last one there as well in that one. So, we'll see about that one when, you know, when we get to that point. because I'm just racking my brains to just go, what happens at the end of Aquas Neverland again? Because it was so long ago now when I recorded this footage. It's like my brain going, can't compute very well. I mean, when did I render this part, actually? Oh! Start of May. Yeah, it has been a while, because I'm now into July, in terms of when this is all happening. And actually, from the looks of things, it was blooming April, when I actually recorded. April, May time, yeah. End of April, start of May when I recorded the footage, so it's been months at this point since I last looked at everything. Although, to be fair, that wasn't Neverland, but it would have been around then anyway, because pretty much whatever I tend to do whenever I'm recording a game is I try to do it all in as short amount of time as possible, because then I retain my skills within the game, so it's never a case of, oh god, it's been like a week since I last recorded, I need to reteach elements of the game to myself so that I know what I'm doing. None of that happens. It's very much just try and blitz through it as quickly as possible, and then just generally I feel a lot happier because then I know that the footage is there. I don't then have to worry about not having enough footage to make it through. And just generally, it's a lot easier on me to get through. And I'm really annoyed that I couldn't make full use of Cinderella's D-Link in that previous room, and I don't think I'm going to get the chance to really do it in this one either. But certainly when, you know, we get to the massive dungeon area, oh boy, will I be making use of D-Links, if I recall correctly. Because, as I said, that's sort of part of my goal with Aqua's story, is to level up every single D-Link as high as possible. Partially because I want to... I wanted to see how close to report completion I could get. The answer being, actually, quite far. The only thing that I was really missing, I think right at the end, was two character entries, which are the super difficult, oh no, three character entries, which are the super difficult optional bosses. And then I think...
Is something wrong?
This a few castle, finish commands.
It's different somehow.
That's about it.
I can't find the princess,
but anyway,
or hear her beautiful voice.
Here we have the prince.
Wait, you mean you know Snow White?
Oh yes, we met once. It was a song that drew us together. Has something happened to the princess?
Yes, I'm afraid so. The wicked queen tricked her into eating a poisoned apple.
I must go to her. Where is she?
In the woods, guarded by seven kind dwarves.
I will find her. Perhaps there's a way I can help.
So yes, the prince is an interesting one, because he's basically one of, if not the least interesting princes throughout the entirety of Disney. He's barely present in the film, just there at the beginning and at the end, and he's just a bit ridiculous, really. I mean, I think from what I recall correctly, they did have a really difficult time actually developing him when they were creating Snow White, because he was the first realistic human male that the Disney animators attempted to bring to life, and because of that he was the hardest of all of them to animate, because obviously you can't make it, because I think the general thing made him look too cutesy and they needed to make him look a little bit more, you know, masculine. But still, obviously in the original film, he was voiced by Harry Stockwell, who, I mean, that's just a great honour, but in Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep here, he is voiced by the awesome James Arnold Taylor, who most people recognise as being the voice of Ratchet in Ratchet & Clank, Tidus in Final Fantasy X, and Obi-Wan Kenobi in various Star Wars animated features and video games. So yeah, James Arnold Taylor's pretty awesome. And I think he does the best job he can do with the prince, because it's kind of a ridiculously pointless character. Other than, you know, being the only one who can wake up Snow White. Because true love's kiss. I don't know why I went into a little bit of Enchanted there. I think it's because whenever I hear the words true love's kiss, I immediately think of the song True Love's Kiss from Enchanted. Because obviously the whole idea of that song is to pay homage to slash kind of take the mickey out of the fact that every Disney princess basically falls in love in about 5 seconds, and everything is magical when you have true love's kiss. And I mean, it's a really fun song. I do love it a lot. So yeah, I'm slightly concerned by I think it's Disenchanted, which is the apparent sequel that is getting made of Enchanted, and my brain's going, just no, please don't do this, please don't do this. And I don't know why I decided to go back for that one when I could have, you know, just got the one on the far end and then come back and got this one, which would have been slightly less work. But hey, once again, Patsby doesn't do logical things sometimes. But it's all okay, because really, since I know what I'm doing at this point, I can just blitz through this entire section. And also, part of me is realising I desperately need a fire move if I'm going to make any decent progress in the next room. Because, kind of need fire in order to light the burners which allow you to get to the higher areas. And thank God I can actually just jump over that one, because otherwise... Oh, there's a fire! Ooh, just in time! Otherwise, that would be a very depressing thing to deal with. And yes, the reason I was waiting for him was because I think the prize pods are meant to appear there, but clearly they're not appearing for me there today. I know they do in somebody else's story. I mean, they do tend to hop around a little bit throughout the story, so it's not the biggest surprise in the world. And oh look, I'm finally using the pots for their primary purpose, other than, you know, just randomly hitting them as I go. But yes, I think it's finally time to do a little bit of levelling up on Cinderella's D-Link, because why not? We've got a room that is absolutely chocker with enemies, so let's just get them murdered. Finally actually pull off her initial finish command, so we've managed to get that, so that's a positive start. Now the question remains, can we level her up in endpoint during this room. I mean, that would certainly be what I would hope for. I mean, the key is going to be don't fall off unless I need to, because while it'll lead me to certain fights, it then means that, you know, I'm not necessarily being as efficient, shall we say, with my enemy murdering. Because that's what I always like to be. I like to be efficient. And there is no way in hell I am going to get that Dewicky sticker up in the top there. It's just not going to happen. Because I need Aqua's dodgy slidey move. Or jumpy slidey move for that one. And waiting for you to come back down, mate. You're just taking your time. As I said, I'm not the biggest fan of Cinderella's finish command. Just because it lifts enemies up out of your reach and then it becomes rather difficult to drag them back down. And that's sort of where the problem comes in. And please? Can I please can I get a level up on Cinderella's D-Link? That would be nice. Yeah, no, it's not happening. Clearly, Dwarf Woodlands hates me and does not want to provide me with such jewels. But I will force it to give it to me at some point in the near future. And here's the point where my brain's going, oh yeah, I need fire for this. Oops. And I'm so close to another level up. Ugh. There we go, finally! And while that means more fighting, which obviously means we're going to get to level 8, there we go, perfecto! I'm still going to be horrifically taunted by that sticker just sitting there, waiting for me to get it, but knowing that I will not be able to. Because you need Double Bounce, which is the super special move that I guess that is unique to her. So it's like how Ben gets Glide and Super Glide, Terra gets Pulse Impact, Aqua gets Double Bounce. I'd say that in the grand scheme of things, Super Glide's probably the most fun to use. But hey. Fire! Freeze! Now, I'm not quite sure what is going through my brain at the minute. Oh yes, you're missing a chest. Go back and get it, is what my brain's saying to me. So, because since it's only, you know, one chest, and while I know that I'm going to have to come back into Dwarf Woodlands to get that sticker much later on down the line, that's also a command or item that I could be using, because if I recall correctly, I think it is, I think it might be Fission Ferrara, just like it was with Terra, but I could be wrong on that. Either way, we should be alright, because I think I've got enough moves in my moveset to do this. Oh, no, I know what I'm doing. I'm being quite sneaky here. Leveling up my D-Link, because I know that... I believe because Cinderella has Wishing Step. Well, is it Wishing Edge? I think it's Wishing Edge. Which is basically the sliding dash type move. Which is really awesome, really helpful, and is going to allow me to make it over that gap, and then I'm just going to be really happy. And the other thing of, you know, going out and getting this means that I can level up Aqua again, which is then going to make the next boss fight even easier. Because you pretty much do want to stay relatively high up in terms of the levels with Aqua, just so that you have that little bit extra success. And, oh! So close! Now, I will succeed with this. Annoyingly, you can't actually grab the top of this. So you pretty much have to jump up there and succeed. But it is a little bit more challenging than it perhaps could be. So yeah, so Enchanted Step is going to be the thing that's going to allow me to get here. I could have done this with Aqua's moveset, because I'm pretty sure that, well, I think I have Barrier Surge. Because that would have done exactly the same thing, and oh yes, it was Fish and Faraga! Get in there! See, actually, do I have... Yeah, I have Barrier Surge, that would have done the job. Clearly, I am a nut job, because that would have been perfect. That would have allowed me to get everything that I wanted, and I would have been happy. But hey, clearly that was not to be. I had to go and use the Cinderella method, but I still managed to get it before we were done with the world, so really, I still come out winning. Now all we have to do is roll right back on through the dungeon area, and obviously I will be doing my fair share of fighting on the way, because we might even be able to level up Aqua. Well, yeah, we are. So we're going to get her up to level 9, which is amazing. I might even be able to get her up to level 10 before the next boss fight. I think going at a pace of 5 levels per world is certainly not going to be bad going. I don't think it's going to remain at that pace, because bloody hell, I think I'd go slightly insane towards the latter part of the game if I were trying to keep up that pace. Because you end up having to require so many experience points that you're just like, yeah, no. Now the question is, will this be the trip through this room that will net me the level ups to Cinderella that I have been after? Clearly right now, not looking so positive, but we've still got quite a bit of the room to go, and also I know where all the enemies are, and yes, get in there, there's one of them. Question is, can I get the double in this room? I mean, that would be ideal. I would totally love that. But I'm not 100% sure that it is going to be possible, because generally it doesn't always work out that way. But I mean, that would certainly make my day if I could. I just need to make sure that I kill these guys off quickly, so that then I can move on to the ones over the other side. And, well, actually I can also go for the ones that are at the top, because the fire's going, so I can... Oh, the fire's not going anymore. Oh well, that's alright, because we can still murder these guys and see whether I get lucky. Because there are plenty of them, so... So come on, please allow me to be a little bit lucky with this. That would be amazing. Come on. please. Pretty, 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 please. It's not going to happen, is it? Yeah, no. Never mind. It's all good. Let's just head on into the throne room and take down our boss, which unfortunately is a repeat of a boss that somebody else has already fought. But it doesn't make it any less fun. So yes, thanks to that potion, the magic mirror is still feeling a little bit crazy, and so we have to take him down. As I said, once again, a little bit disappointing that we have to face him again, but it is still quite a fun fight, and it's also particularly fun with Aqua, because having those magic attacks mean that you can target more effectively and just generally cause chaos. And also, I think at some point I'm going to use Ragnarok and just completely and utterly wreck him. At least I seem to recall that happening. We'll see whether I was actually correct, but he definitely ain't going to make it very far, let's put it that way. Oh yeah, here comes the Ragnarok, and so long, Magic Mirror, and that brings us to a wonderful end, and it is actually a wonderful end, to the Dwarf Woodlands. Yay!
The Queen is gone, my service done. Adieu, O victorious one.
Princess! Ventus, why won't you wake up? You're awake! Ventus! Oh, it's a miracle! Terra! Master Eric! Marcus! Ventus is awake! Every waking is a new journey. Maybe Vent left because it was his time.